Can you tell me a little bit about the personalities of the classes? I mean, do people tend to get along? How do they interact while they're there? Are there a lot of questions asked?
So today we're going to talk about upper motor neuron lesions, but before we begin, does anyone have any questions from last week? Sam?
So I was looking through your notes, and you gave us a page number for the dermatomes in Netters, but the one in neuroanatomy through clinical cases looks a little bit different. Which one do you want us to use?
Great question, Sam. You know, I'm going to take a look at that, but first let me pass out these notes. Going to have to email you that information. So let's get started for today. Does anyone not have a handout? So now that everyone has the notes, let's go ahead and get started. We're going to start off with talking about upper motor neuron lesions. So the first, Erin.
I have a clarifying question. I saw a patient with a stroke. Is that an upper motor neuron lesion?
Yes, it is.
Actually, I was in Venezuela probably a few years ago, and I saw this guy. I was like, I don't know, it's like a nighttime. There was, yes, a lot of people around. So, I mean, in terms of upper motor neuron stuff, I was thinking about this guy because, you know, like we were in the dance floor, and then all of a sudden I saw him, he was dancing ring it and got all pale and stuff. And I don't know, I thought that maybe that's, you know, he was having a stroke.
Yeah.
Actually, Marianne, some of the new literature showing that people who dance merengue are four times as likely to have stroke than other types of dance. It comes in highest on the SITOD scale, stroke-induced types of dance.
Actually, the most stroke-inducing type of dance is a MoMA, rattlesnake dance, in South Africa.
Yeah. So, I guess what I'm thinking is, we're talking about merengue being a risk factor for stroke, and they were talking about other stroke-inducing type of dances. But I guess what I want to know is, does any of it really matter?
I don't know. Let's just start today's lecture.
So upper motor neuron systems refer to the central nervous system. So please take a look at the brain side that I have.
Crazy. I'm crazy for feeling.
Good job with the scalpel there. This is what you need though. Let's get in there. Good. Perfect.
I've paid my dues time after time. I've done my sentence but committed no crime. And bad mistakes, I've made a few. I've had my shells and kicked in my back, but I've come through.
I need to go home.
Okay, for the next 15 minutes, we'll generate some discussion about last week's cases because you guys came up with some really great ideas. Really respect where you guys are coming from, especially the breadth of your experience. Then we'll take a 15-minute break, and we'll break out into groups. We'll take the pulse on how you guys are feeling about breaking out into the groups, but let's talk about this first case. All right, Andy, and then Jessica, and then we'll move on.
So at my last clinical placement, we used the Wii, and that's so much more cost-effective because the Balance Master costs tens and thousands. And I mean, can you talk about how that could be a benefit of using the Wii?
I really appreciate your input. What I hear you saying is that the Wii is a financially feasible adjunct to traditional balance treatment. That shows some deep thinking. Okay, Jess and Lizzie, and then we'll wrap this section up.
I refer the patient for a cardiac stress test, but not the cardiopulm test. She seems to have some risk factors for coronary artery disease, so by doing a stress test, we'd be able to see the perfusion of her heart a little bit better.
To be honest with you, that's not something I did, but I really should have. I really respect your approach. I hear you saying that it's important, both in terms of practice and for myself. So I really appreciate the input in class. I'd like to keep doing this. All right, Lizzie, Melissa, and then we've really got to close this out.
I think we're missing the big point here. The patient came in complaining of knee pain, so I would want to focus on that.
One thing that is also on the list, I appreciate everything you're saying, is that given this, that my first thought, I didn't offer any care, I appreciate everything you've said. I take these points, I think you handle that, I think you got it, you can do that yourselves as well, so there you go. I really hate to cut the discussion short, so we'll do Melissa, Anna, Tara, Tommy, Liz, Becca, Becky.
So, yeah, I've also heard that you have excellent clinical education program here. I was wondering if you could tell me a little more about that.
We have an excellent clinical matching process. Our clinical coordinator's excellent. They really care about where you go, and it's not just one of those things where you're a number and you get matched as your number.